Hi there, this is Unmesh from Pix Imperfect, and today I'm going to share with you how to create a natural and realistic canvas mockup with Photoshop. All you have to do is to just drag and drop your photo and the template will take care of the rest. It will automatically blend the photo according to the canvas. Also, we're going to make the template absolutely customizable. So without any further ado, let's get started. Back in the magical world of Photoshop, and if you want to go ahead and download this photo and follow along, you already know what to do. Check the links in the description. Now, the first thing we need to do here is to create a placeholder. A placeholder is a place which holds the image, or in other words, it's a place where you're going to drag and drop your new photos. So let's go ahead and create a brand new layer by clicking on the new layer icon right there, and let's name this placeholder. There you are. The next step is to actually create a placeholder just above the canvas. And for that, we're going to use the rectangular marquee tool. Now, keep in mind, I want you to have a close look. This is not an absolute rectangle, right? There are bumps here and there, right? It's not an absolute rectangle. However, for smart objects to work properly for replacing images, it has to be rectangle. What do we do now? First, let's create a rectangle, just leaving a little space outside of it. So we're going to start from right here and just make sure we are leaving some space. There you go. All right. Make sure the rectangle we created is outside the bounds of the canvas. A little bit space is left. Once we have done that, we need to fill it with a color that can represent a wide variety of images. Guess what that color is? 50% gray, because it's in the middle of everything, right? So let's make sure that the foreground color is 50% gray. Double click on the foreground color box right there, and let's choose 808080 or RGB all at 128. Hit OK. Now that the foreground color is gray, just press Alt Backspace on Windows or Option Delete on a Mac. Then press Control or Command D to deselect. However, do keep in mind that when we created this rectangle, we left a little space. There is a gap, right? Now we need to make sure that the placeholder is only applied to that canvas. And for that, we need to create a mask. But before we create any mask or do anything with this layer, let's change this into a smart object. So with the placeholder layer selected, let's go to Filter and then Convert for Smart Filters, hit OK, so that it becomes easy for us to replace it. Now, let's turn it off for a moment, and you can take all the time in the world to create a proper selection of this. You can use the quick selection tool, the pen tool, whatever is your favorite. So to save time, I went ahead, I used the pen tool to make a selection of it. I'm just going to load the selection. This is not a selection class. So I'm just going to go to select and then load selection. And I had created this selection, canvas selection right there. And there you go. So in this, I used the pen tool to create a selection of this canvas. You can use any tool that you like. All you have to keep in mind is to make a selection as accurate as possible. Have a look. Once you have the selection ready, let's turn on the placeholder and then click on the mask button right there. All right. Now it's exactly falling on the canvas. Isn't that amazing? Now the canvas is white, right? Let's turn it off. Let's have a look. The canvas is white. Whatever we paint on it is going to make it what? Darker, right? And what is the blend mode which makes things darker? Anything in the darken blend mode group. However, in this case, we're going to use multiply. Let's turn it on and have a look. We're going to choose multiply. It looks right. At this moment, actually, we can stop. However, we still need some lights and shadow control over it. Because as is, if you place your image right here, it's going to look fake. So to create lights and shadows, we're going to make two copies of the original image right there. So select the background layer and then press Control or Command J twice. We have two copies. One, we're going to name it light. And the other, we're going to name this shadow. All right. Now we're going to place it on top of the placeholder. So shadow and then light. First, let's work with shadow. I have turned off the light momentarily. Now, this is only creating lights and shadows. We don't want involvement of any color in this case. So let's take away the colors by desaturating it. To desaturate it, press Control Shift U or Command Shift U. Once it's desaturated, what blend mode do you think darkens or creates shadows? We just used it. Multiply, right? So change the blend mode from normal to multiply. This is perfect. We need to make the shadows even darker. You know why? So that we can control that later according to the image that we have, because different images will require different amounts of shadows and lights. So let's go ahead and create a curves adjustment layer by clicking on the adjustment layer icon and then choose curves. And we're gonna take it down just a little bit, right? At this point, this is affecting all of the image. We don't want that. We want the curves to affect only the shadow. So hold the Alt key or the Option key and click on the line between these two layers. Now the curves is limited just to the shadow layer. Alternatively, let me redo that. You can open the curves properties by double clicking on the symbol right there and then click on this button. It also creates a clipping mask. However, still, there's something wrong, right? The shadow layer that we created is being applied over the entire image and not just the canvas. So we need to make sure that it's only affecting the canvas. And how can we make sure that happens? Just simply copy the mask. So hold the Alt key or the Option key, click and drag the mask on the shadow layer. All right, now let's go ahead and turn on the light. Also, we are dealing with light. We don't want any color to be involved, right? So desaturate it by pressing Command Shift U. It's desaturated. Now, what is the blend mode which brightens stuff? Screen, right? Or any blend mode in the lighten group. So let's go ahead and change the blend mode from normal to screen. But you know, it's very, very light. It's very bright. So how do we control that? Again, curves, right? The problem here is it's also brightening the shadows. We don't want that. We want to keep the highlights in the highlight areas, but we don't want to brighten the shadows, right? So click on the adjustment layer icon and then choose curves. Now, we just want to limit the curves to the light layer. So click on this button, create clipping mask button. Now, we will create a point on the right-hand side. It will maintain the light. And on the left-hand side, we're going to create a point and then just bring it down. Just like that. That'll make sure that only the brights are enhanced. There we go. That kind of looks good. You can make little adjustments here and there. And there we are. Now, it again also affects the entire image. We don't want that. We just want it to affect the canvas. So what do? We can either copy the same mask there, or you know what we can do? We can make an entire group of the lights and shadows. So select the shadow layer. Hold the Shift key, select the topmost layer, and then press Control or Command G, right? And then you can actually move this mask on the shadow layer to the entire group, so you won't have to create multiple masks. So let's move it to the group. There you have it. Here's before, here's after. Now that's what I'm talking about. Even in this case, I think the light is kind of too much. So let's decrease the opacity of the light to 40%. And also, let's decrease the opacity of the shadow to 40% as well. This looks perfect. Let's just minimize the group and we can name the group lights and shadows. There we are. So without the group, it's too flat. It doesn't look right. But with it, it looks excellent. Now, I'm going to share with you how to save it as a template because that's an essential trick too. So let's go to File and then Save As. I want to save it on my computer, of course. And let's name this as Canvas Template, and this is essential, my friend. Instead of saving it as .psd, we're going to save it as .psdt, where T stands for template. So .psdt, all right, and hit save. Hit OK. Now, we're going to go ahead and close it. Now, here's the great part. Here we are in our Finder or Explorer, and if we open the psdt file, have a look what it does. It's going to create a brand new Photoshop document, untitled one, and it does not disturb the template file. The template file stays intact. If you had saved it as a PSD, you had opened it, you had brought in an image, and then saved it, it would be saved as the same file and the template would be altered. We don't want that. Every time you open a PSDT, let's not save it. Every time you open a PSDT file, it will open a brand new Photoshop document with the exact same content. And then you can save that version of it. Let me show you how this can be useful. I'm going to close everything. All right. In one of the versions, let's just open this again. All right. I want to bring in my face, my beautiful and handsome face, by double clicking on the placeholder. And all you've got to do is to go to a Finder or File Explorer, locate the photo. So this is the photo that I'm gonna use. I'm just gonna drag it and drop it inside of it. And let's adjust it. By the way, I made this with the help of Prisma app. Have you ever used that? It's pretty cool. All right, hit enter or return. I have positioned it. Position it according to your tastes and then press Control or Command S. Now let's get back to this. Have a look. It's updated. Isn't that amazing? Now, on top of that, you can control the shadow and the lighting. So if you want less lighting, you can just go to the left-hand side. So I'm going to go with less lighting on this one, probably about 30% lighting. How much shadow you want on this one? So shadow, you can increase or decrease the shadow. So I think I'm going to go with about 50% on this one. And it looks great to me. On top of that, if you want to make some additional adjustments with curves, you can do that as well. So click on the adjustment layer icon and then choose curves. And probably you want to fade the artwork a little bit by holding the Alt or Option. Click on the line between these two or click on this button so that it only limits to the artwork. Then you can just fade in the shadows and adjust accordingly. But all you had to do, just drag and drop. And then if you want, you can just customize it. Customize the lights, customize the shadows. In this case, I wanted, you know, a little less light and probably a little more shadows. All right, there you have it. Let's zoom in. Look, all the textures of the canvas show up. Everything is looking so realistic and nice. If you just zoom in and have a look, it's so good, isn't it? So this, my friend, is version 1. You didn't have to alter the canvas template. Now I can just directly go to File and then Save or Save As. Even if I choose Save, it's going to ask you to type in the file name. So I'm going to type Unmesh 1. Done. This is Unmesh 1. The canvas template is still not altered. That's crazy, isn't it? Now, let's just close this. Let's open the canvas template again. So I'm just going to double click on the canvas template and it again opens another brand new document. And this time I want a bright version. In that case, maybe I will need different values of highlights and shadows. So double click on the placeholder thumbnail and then just open up your File Explorer or Finder and locate the artwork or the photo that you want to attach there. So this is the second image that I want to attach. I'm just going to drag it and drop it over right here. Again, this was also made with the Prisma app. Pretty cool. All right, I'm going to keep it like this. Probably something like this. We can always adjust this later, but anyway, you get the point. Hit enter or return, Control or Command S, and then let's go back here and have a look. In this case, probably I will need some more shadows. So let's just open that lights and shadows group and scroll down and increase the shadows. There you have it. And maybe a little less lighting. Or who knows, a little more. You can always control it to your taste. And there you have it. You could have even left it at 40-40 opacity or just go ahead and customize the template because it's customizable. There you have it. That's how to create a realistic canvas mockup in Photoshop. Before we finish, just a quick little reminder. All you have to do is to first create a placeholder. Every mockup has to have a placeholder. This is where you're going to drop the image. So, once you create a rectangle, just leaving a little space, don't forget to convert it into a smart object. And after that, you're going to use the exact selection of the canvas and create a mask out of it. Simple. Changing the blend mode to multiply will allow you to blend it better because this is a white canvas. Everything we paint on it, it's going to make it dark. So, we changed the blend mode to multiply. And after that, if it was not enough, because in this case, it was looking flat. So we created, again, some highlights and shadows to go along with it, to add some punch to it. So in this case, we made two copies of the background layer, two copies of the original image, and then one for the shadows, one for the highlights. For the shadows, we chose a blend mode which makes things darker. And what is that? Multiply. And for the highlights, we chose a blend mode which makes things brighter. And that is screen. And then you can control it with curves according to your tastes and then just make sure it is only applied to that of the canvas. And once you have created the perfect template, save it as a PSDT, where T stands for template. And every time you open a PSDT file, what happens? It creates a brand new document without disturbing the original template file. And then all you have to do is to double click on the thumbnail of the placeholder and replace it with whatever you like and then press Control or Command S and the original document would update. I hope this video made some sense to you, and if it did, make sure to give us a like, and also don't forget to subscribe, and not just subscribe, ring the bell so that you, my friend, don't miss any other future tips, tricks, or tutorials. I would like to take this moment to thank all these nice and amazing people for supporting this channel on Patreon and helping keep Pix Imperfect free for everybody forever. Thanks so much for all your support. Thank you for watching. I'll see you guys in my next one. Till then, stay tuned and make sure that you keep creating.